Good morning, everyone. We're continuing over here in the words of the Kitzur, Shulhan Aruch, and we began the laws of Chol HaMoed, so we should understand what we can and cannot do. Meleches davar avod, the malacha, activities that are needed for something called a davar avod, which we defined as a financial loss, which is going to take place if I don't do it right now. Even on Chol HaMoed, Yochel Aseis Gama Yidei Yisrael Acher, you could even use another Jew to do those, afilu b'schar, even if you want to do it for payment. Now, the Be'er Halacha, which is the Chofetz Chaim, brings down that not everybody agrees with this, and therefore it is better not to hire a Jew to do the davra of it, the work, the financial loss work over here. Rather, you should hire a non-Jew. Only if you get into a situation where there is no non-Jew that is available, would you be permitted then to hire a Jew under the circumstances. However, something that's not going to incur a financial loss, however, it is a need of the Mayid, of the Chol HaMoed, or the Chag, or the Yom Tiv, don't hire another Jew and pay him. In that case, you must use a non-Jew. If you cannot find a non-Jew, and you yourself are not able to do it, then you'd be allowed to pay another Jew. For example, let's say that your sink broke over Yom Tiv, so it has to be fixed over Chol HaMoed. You need your water. So really, lechatchila says the Kitzur, you have to hire a non-Jew to do it. If you can't find a non-Jew, then you can do it yourself. If you're not a plumber and you can't do it yourself, at that point you'd be able to hire a Jew. Had the mutala says davar ovid, this that we said, you're allowed to do davar ovid, things that'll cause that are financial losses that could get incurred over Chol HaMoed. So dafkim la'yev shalai la seisa kaidu Yom Tov. That's only if you weren't able to do before Yom Tov began. Avim ha'yo efshalai la seisa kaidu Yom Tov. However, if you were able to do it before Yom Tov began, and you just decide, you know what, I'll leave it around to Chol HaMoed. I don't have time right now. I'm very busy getting ready for Yom Tov. Okay, I'll call the repair guy on Chol HaMoed. Then you cannot do this on Chol HaMoed. So this is a very important point over here. And that is that if something you know is going to be a financial loss, and you could have taken care of it before Yom Tov, and you decided not to. For example, let's say it'll be for watering a field, and you could have done it before Yom Tov, and you decided not to. So then, says the Kitzur, you don't have a right to save yourself from the financial loss on Chol HaMoed. However, if you had no time, let's say that you needed to build a wall or the like in your house, you needed to repair something, and you simply ran out of time. You kept trying to make that call. You never got through to the repairman. So then you can do it on Chol HaMoed. Any malach, any work that you're not allowed to do on Chol HaMoed, im yesh kan Yisrael, if there's a Yid, a Jew around, she'en lo malechol karoy, he doesn't have enough food for Yom Tov, l'chol HaMoed v'Yom Tov, either for Chol HaMoed and for Yom Tov, mut la'aseisan, ayana, you can hire the Jew, k'dei shu'loy malechol, in order that he has what to eat. U'mikol malchum, nevertheless, yaseh b'tzina, he should do it privately, v'yaseh la'aseisan al yidei akum, and you cannot do it through a non-Jew, ach l'tzarech mitzvah mutter. So what the kids are speaking about over here is that if you have something that is not really a davar avod, there's no impending financial loss over here, then you cannot ask a non-Jew to do it. Only in that case, if you have a Jew that is suffering and struggling for money, would he be allowed to do such a thing. However, he does write, Ach l'tzarech mitzvah mutter, if it's for the sake of a mitzvah, then in fact you would be able to ask the non-Jew to do it in this particular situation, because you're benefiting from the ability to do the mitzvah during Chol HaMoed or Yom Tov. Have a wonderful day and a good Yom Tov. All the best.